stop up the street at the hamburger joint because I got to get something to eat because this thing is about 45, maybe an hour away, and there ain't no place over there to eat.
It's like it was the end of the month and everything, and I was broke. My old man split, and I didn't have any money. So I started looking, I thought about looking for a job. So I looked in the paper and all, and just saw all these ads with that you can make a lot of money with hardly any hours and stuff. So I called up to find out about it and went down for an interview, you know, at a parlor. And I figured I could handle whatever they had to put out. So I said I'd try it to see what happened with it. Whether it was going to make me any money or I was going to be just as broke as before, I figured 1 or 2 days couldn't hurt. When I was little, like, my dad used to be an alcoholic. And, like, when I was little, he used to sleep in the next room on a couch and shit. And one night, he woke up in the middle of the night and didn't know where he was or nothing because he was really drunk. And he came in. And, like, he came into my room, and he was so disoriented that he urinated all over the wall. And that just really scared me. And, you know, like, I think about it a lot. Maybe that's why I got into this, because I just hated that so much. It really scared me, you know. It did something to my mind, because I think, like, a lot of times, I just wonder, you know, like, if that started me off on all this stuff about not being able, well, I can handle men, you know, I don't got no problem, but I mean, like, that did something to my mind. It affected me somehow, and maybe I think that I'm getting back at them or something in some strange way. You know, some of them tell me they think it's neat, you know, that I can just, you know, go out all night and go and meet all these different people and stuff. But, like, a lot of them think you're just, like, a lot of guys do think, you know, that you're just doing it for the money. And they understand, you know, that if you have a straight job and you only make $80 a week, you know, you can't make it. It's a way for a girl to make enough money to survive on. In the beginning, I'd say almost all of them, you know, when they're just on the, at the point of talking on the telephone and everything, that the majority of them are out for sex. But I think after the girl gets there and they realize that she's just a normal, everyday human being and stuff, that they sit there and talk to you. But eventually, I'd say about 50% of them come out and ask you about sex. I think most of them do it probably either because they're lonely and they just want somebody to talk to, or because they're mad and they want to get back at their old lady. So they figure even if they don't know about it, just the fact that they're doing it is enough to get back at them, you know. Say, oh, I had a strange girl over and we sat there and we massaged each other and everything, and we talked and we had a good time, you know. And even though they won't tell their wife about it, you know, they think they're getting over on them.
In the pool halls, the hustlers and the losers used to watch them through the glass. Well, I'd stand outside at closing time just to watch her walk on past. Unlike all the other ladies, she looked so young and sweet as she made her way down that empty street, down on Main Street. Down on Main Street. Ooh.
I don't know, I mean, everybody wants to get married and have kids, but, for right now, you know, I'm just trying to stay ahead. And every time I turn around, I get pushed back. And this is just to try and keep myself above water. Like to get out of debt.
Sometimes even now, when I'm feeling lonely and beat, I drift back in time and I find my feet down on Main Street.